The people are excited to, you know, have you here, and they accept you with open arms. So I think it's a special feeling, and, you know, it's a feeling like no other. And, you know, if I'm an NBA guy, young or old, you know, you definitely should make this trip and experience this.
Okay, you're here as an NBA ambassador for partnerships in the NBA. How does it feel that this game has become really global, beyond people here in the Philippines know your name?
It's amazing. You know, it's beyond our wildest dreams, because, you know, when you first start out playing a game of basketball, you start off at a park, and then you start off in your neighborhood, and then a side of town hear about you. So if I'm from the north side, the south side hear about me, and then my city know about me, and then the next city over know about me. This is a whole nother world removed. We're in Manila, we're in the Philippines, and they know about you all the way over here. So that just goes to show you, like, how the game has expanded, and how, like, so many folks are, like, embracing the culture and the game of basketball. And it's an exciting time. Like, I'm so excited to be here. Like, and it's an amazing experience. The chance of a lifetime to come here, be on this trip, talk about the game of basketball, expand the game of basketball, and educate about the game of basketball.
Brian, what's your message to small kids from small towns in the Philippines who are dreaming big to go to the NBA?
Man, see it as believing you can do it. Stay determined, stay dedicated, stay disciplined. That's the 3 D's. And, you know, stay inspired. You know, I think it's all about staying goal-oriented. Sometimes in life, people lack consistency, because if they set a goal and they reach that goal, you know, they don't continue to set new goals. So I think it's important that you set new goals, continue to move forward, and stay inspired in anything can happen.
I remember doing your Washington D.C. card. I got to LeBron James. Right now, at the evolution of LeBron James, how do you compare him when you were competing against Washington and the Dallas Mavericks?
He's still the same. No drop off. He's only got better from a physical standpoint, from an intellectual standpoint. His basketball IQ is superb. He's a guy that takes care of his temple, meaning his body. And it's amazing just to see, you know, so many final appearances, so many Olympic runs, and how he continues to excel and get better. He has no decline factor nowhere there. Like, he's continued to move forward in progress. So it's amazing to see that. I think he's once in a lifetime generational type player and talent. And I look forward to seeing him for years to come.
Okay, talk about that. I mean, it's about, of course, being tough. And of course, life is tough for a lot of people. And, talk about all the trials coming up
at
this
moment. I think it's most importantly about this overcoming adversity. And it's about coming from tough situations, tough environments, and about coming out of those tough environments and those tough situations. It's about being inspired when people will suspect you not to be inspired. It's about seeing the bigger picture when people don't see it. It's about when people say no, you say yes. It's about overcoming real life situations. And I think that's the most important take from it. You know, if I can do it, you can do it. And that's why I put it out there. I wanted to plant that seed of information to the youth and to people in general from all different walks of life.
Thank you so much.
Just one question.
Okay. Yeah.